Good evening. Tonight, we're going to take a hard, tough, abrasive look at camel spotting. Hello.
Hello, Peter.
Now, tell me, what exactly are you doing?
Well, I'm camel spotting. I'm spotting to see if there are any camels that I can spot and put them down in my camel spotting book.
Good. And how many camels have you spotted so far?
Well, so far, Peter, up to the present moment, I've spotted nearly one.
Nearly one?
Call it none.
Fine. And how long have you been here?
3 years.
So, in 3 years, you've spotted no camels?
Yes, in only 3 years. I tell a lie, four. Be fair, five. I've been camel spotting for just the 7 years. Before that, of course, I was a Yeti spotter.
A Yeti spotter? That must have been extremely interesting.
Oh, it was extremely interesting. Very, very... quite. It was dull. Dull, dull, dull. Oh, God, it was dull. Sitting in the Waterloo waiting room. Of course, once you've seen one Yeti, you've seen them all.
And have you seen them all?
Well, I've seen one. Well, a little one. A picture of a I've heard about them.
Well, now, tell me, what do you do when you spot a camel?
I take its number.
Camels don't have numbers.
Oh, well, you've got to know where to look. They're on the side of the engine above the piston box.
What?
Of course, you've got to make sure it's not a dromedary, because if it's a dromedary, it goes in the dromedary book.
Well, how do you tell if it's a dromedary?
Well, a dromedary has one hump, and a camel has a refreshment car, buffet and ticket collector.
Mr. Sopwith, aren't you, in fact, a train spotter?
What?
Don't you, in fact, spot trains?
Oh, you're no fun anymore.
Oh, no, Rashid, we can't want a meeting like this.
Oh, you're no fun anymore.